COVID-19 low-cost oral intranasal inhalable treatment in works. Covistat is repurposing nafamostat for COVID-19. The drug's action blocks human host cells, not SARS-CoV-2. The blocking action restricts the life cycle of the novel coronavirus inside the human body. The company sees potential in the drug based on lab-based evidence against COVID-19 and MERS. The repurposing strategy became possible after the acquisition of Mucokinetica's technology. It accelerated efforts to develop a low-cost treatment for COVID-19. Dr. Lynn Kirkpatrick, CEO at Covistat, said, "The Mucokinetica team has dedicated their lives to fighting devastating diseases. Together, we can formulate the safest, most accessible treatment to reduce progression of this powerful virus and help protect against COVID-19, as well as future strains and other seasonal coronaviruses. Without nafamostat, the spike proteins of SARS-CoV-2 could easily bind to the ACE2 receptor of human cells. The binding secures invasion of the cell and creation of new viral copies. But with nafamostat, an enzyme called TMPSRR2 would be inhibited. It disallows the activation of the spike proteins." In the journal Cell, the authors revealed that both SARS-CoV and SARS-CoV-2 use ACE2 receptors to infect cells. The spike proteins in these coronaviruses also need TMPSRR2. Inhibitors of the enzyme work significantly on SARS-CoV, while moderately on SARS-CoV-2. Meanwhile, the study published on BioRxiv showed the action of nafamostat against the enzyme. In vitro assays confirmed the two inhibitors interfered with the enzyme. The drugs were camostat and nafamostat. Via modeling, authors analyzed how both drugs work against the enzyme and how long they could inhibit it. Results showed that inhibitory properties were caused by binding with TMPRSS2, but nafamostat expressed greater efficacy than camostat against the enzyme. According to PR Newswire, the company is repurposing nafamostat into oral, intranasal, and inhalable therapies for COVID-19. The development includes patients in developed and remote regions. Intravenous administration is currently off the table because of major issues. First, it is more expensive to develop. And second, the high cost will make the drug less accessible for many people around the world. Furthermore, the oral version is easier to manage. Oral drugs are highly manageable for transport and can last longer in storage. Hospitals do not have to obtain special storage to store oral nafamostat. But intranasal and inhalable variants may require stricter storage procedures. The company expects nafamostat to lower SARS-CoV-2 viral loads in patients and prevent COVID-19 progression.